Good day, fellas. I hope you're ready for your daily dose of skill. And today we are going to play with a classical tank destroyer 268. Funny fact, this tank used to be one of the best, if not the best, tank destroyer back in 2013-14 when the camo mechanics was different, when alpha damage was 850. And if I'm not mistaken, this tank used to have like 50 camo percentage or something. So it used to be a real ninja turtle, if I remember that correctly. Although I might be wrong. Anyways, the plan is simple. We are going to play the 3 battles with this vehicle, and after that we are moving to the next day, right? One more thing which I want to ask, fellas, for you: what tanks you would love to see next? Because we are getting close to finish all tier 10s, we have only a couple of tanks left. If you are wondering which tanks we are going to deal next or very very soon to finish the tier 10s, Patton, 268, Object 705A, Double Penetration ST2, and that's it. All tier 10 tanks is done. And you might think, but Skill, I missed the video. It's very very easy. First of all, check description or the first pinned comment, click on the link and you will get into the Skill Baboon Dog, and then click on the YouTube and you will find all information right there. Anyways, tier 10s is almost finished. We started the tier 9s already a bit, some tier 8s. So whatever you want to see in action, feel free to say in the comment section down below and I will try to make it happen. Obviously, I will try to check. I can't check all comments, but I will check some of them, and especially the ones which have the most likes on. So I will try to make it happen for you, fellas. Anyways, enough of rambling, time to start playing. So, Object, you know, I'm not a big fan of this tank because, in my opinion, currently in the current game meta, this tank is nothing special. It is typical bushwhacker. Although you could potentially go in front, you can fall back, you can do whatever if you want, but in the same time, it's just not interesting. I am missing a spark on this vehicle or something, right? But once again, it's only my opinion about it. I'm not saying it's bad. I'm saying it's not interesting for me, and in a way, it is a boring tank. That's what I would say, right? Anyways, instead of complaining, let's go and let's do some stuff. What do I want to do? I want to take this position over there so we can Kaku on the Heavis, which is playing around this area, or alternatively we can do a bad things for a people which is playing over there. And we have all time in the world of tanks. So chill, relax, get yourself popcorn, candy or kvass, and let's go. I remember, like I said in the past, it used to be the primary choice as a heavy, as a tank destroyer. It is insane how times changed nowadays, and as wrong as it sounds, you are rarely seeing this tank in the battlefield, right? At least I don't see this tank too often in the game. Or maybe it's only me, right? Anyways, Leo is over there. We definitely cannot punish Leo. But look, my mission with this vehicle is extremely simple. All I need to do, I need to be patient and I need to wait until some people will come to this area, or alternatively try to make a pressure like this. Either way, we can punish enemy forces for their stupidity or for their pressure, for their actions, whatever. All we need to do, we need to be patient. That's it. And this is the whole play when there is a couple of clickers in the game and so on, so on. It's simply pointless for you to make a pressure in front, right? Just simply pointless. So what we are doing, we missed our shot. We are taking the coffee in one hand and we are simply waiting. 650. And we are simply waiting, boys and girls. We are just waiting. And now you might think, but Skill, it's a good score. Yes, it is, but in the same time, it's it's kind of boring in a way, right? But we can probably say that about every single tank, right? The light tanks is boring because you are sitting in the bush and you are not doing too much. Or the tank destroyers is kind of boring because you are sitting in the bush in the back and you are playing like this. Artas is boring because you are clicking the button. Heavy tanks have armor, so it's boring because no one can penetrate you. So probably we can say this about every single vehicle, but in the same time, if you want to be competitive with those, you need to know when to make pressure, how to make pressure, what to do, and with what to do, right? For example, now, let's get real. My knowledge and my performance in this battle, I'm just sitting in the back and waiting until enemies are going to make one or another mistake. This is my performance, what I am doing right here, right? And you know what is the funny thing of all this? It works. Just because I predicted where enemies are going to go and I'm just sitting in the bush like this and punishing them for their mistakes or for their decisions, what they are doing in the battle. And for example, now we need to start moving because we can't get enough use of this, right? So currently I am just moving in, and my first thing what I want to do, I want to eliminate this Leo. But before eliminating this Leo, maybe we can get a shot into this 60 TP though. Actually no, 60 TP is already running away. Now pay attention at the speed of this vehicle. Speed of this vehicle is not horrible, okay? I mean 42 kilometers per hour or something, it's very, very, very good speed. And armor is not horrible on this vehicle because you can actually bounce one or another shot, right? But the thing is, for some reason I don't feel it. I do not feel this vehicle whatsoever. I don't really know why, but I simply don't feel it. But skill, how dare you? You have 100% of the mark of excellence and you are not feeling it. Eat kaku. Now, for real, there are some tanks, even though the tanks is not good overall, which I might like quite a bit. And there is some tanks which is either good or very good, for example, Super Conqueror, but I simply don't like it. So same goes for this vehicle, right? The first battle, which we had right there, is very, very good. We did everything properly. We took the best position which we could at the time, and we pretty much punished every single enemy right there which was making one or another mistake, right? Hip hip hooray, that was nice. I am happy about this performance. Now, you know what? The question is, Chieftain is going to make a pressure? Yes, he will. It's completely fine. Everything is Gucci. We are just going in right here. All we need to do, boys, we need to get a bit closer right here to shoot the Chieftain once or twice, and life is going to be beautiful from that moment, right? That's what we need to do. Chieftain. Oh, Chieftain. Kaboom. Beautiful. Beautiful. As you can see, our performance in this battle is actually fine. What we did right here, we read everything properly, we did the things well, and we simply can I say outplayed enemies, outcamped enemies in a way, right? Our predictions was right, and we did a good decisions at the right time, which is very, very good shit. Now wait, BR is going to move like this. Butts. That was perfect. That was perfect. You can say whatever if you want. I played this battle like a bloody boss. I went into the left, I went to the right, I punished enemies until I could punish them. Then I made a pressure when I needed to, then I hit majority of my shots. If I'm not mistaken, I missed only one shot in this battle. If I am not mistaken right here, let's see. Yeah, 10 out of 10 direct hits, well, 11 shots, 10 direct hits, 10 penetrations. We did everything ideally in this battle, and I'm actually very, very, very happy with this performance. That was beautiful one. Anyways, let's keep going. Two more battles left with a 268. And once again, this time can work. I'm not saying it's bad. I'm saying it's boring. But once again, it is only for me. And fellas, I'm very, very curious about your opinion. What do you think about 268? Because this is one of the most popular tank destroyers over there, following with, together with like Jackpista, E4, E3. It's one of the, you know, those tank destroyers which people actually used to grind and which a lot of people have, especially you, if you are old school player, right? Maybe you went for this line. Why people used to grind this? Because the whole road towards the 268 is actually good. Su 150 is something. The derp one. ISU. Object 704, and this one, you know, the road for this vehicle is quite good, and the grind overall was easy in a way. High alpha damage, good tanks, fellas. Okay. This is interesting stuff. Why the flying F hour T95 is going here, I don't know, but it doesn't matter, right? Let's see. Raise the gun. And go to this position. Now, all we need to do, we need to wait until the enemies are going to make one or another mistake. All we need to wait until the enemies will do one or another mistake, fellas. Patience. Blind shot. Such an unfortunate timing for a blind shot. Holy moly, guacamole. That was bad. Oh well, it happens. Not every single time you can predict the things, right? Now, blind shot over there, definitely not a blind shot. By the way, probably we missed all of those shots. Now I'm not going to hide behind the budget because that would be a dick move. I am just going to fall back so this budget is not going to get hit, right? This is the plan, and this is very, very, very important thing. Let's see. Aiming, kaboom. 700 in the face. Good. So far, so good. I'm very, very happy with this, with my decisions, what I am making right here, right? But it's still not even close for being over. There is a lot of things which we need to do. STB over there. Kaboom. You know, looking into this gun handling, looks like this vehicle have a Russian roots, right? Well, it's Russian tank after all, right? So, not a big surprise over there. But by saying it has Russian roots, I mean you can actually hit your shots relatively well with this vehicle, as you can see yourself. But in the same time, battle is not equal for a battle. Sometimes you can hit shots extremely easily and sometimes you are missing fully aimed shots. RNG is still playing a very, very, very big part in this game, right? Wait. That was perfect. I mean, by saying perfect, I mean we maybe could hit him if the... if everything would be aligned, but it's okay. No complaints and no regrets, boys. We are losing this battle completely and not much what we can do about this. Although, I would love to clear the side completely, right? What we want to do, we want to clear the side. Hopefully it's going to work. If the T95 maybe would go with us, maybe then it would be a tiny touch better situation. I don't know. Time will show everything. Let's go. I'm making a hardcore pressure right there. Aiming. Boom. 800 in the face. That's quite nice. Good. Oh, TVP is sitting over there. Okay, I'm turning my front into the TVP and now we know this. TVP is over there, right? I mean, we kind of knew it before. And look, in this kind of situation, fellas, I couldn't play in this city, at least in my opinion, because once again, for example, e4 have an advantage over this tank, because e4 have a turret, right? Unexpected. Turret is an advantage, right? The heavy tanks could get us on track, and then it's pretty much GG, game over and everything. It's not that simple as you might think it is. It's just not that simple, boys and girls. And you actually, you can't be that aggressive, like to go full trollolo mode and expect for the best thing ever idea. It's just not how the things is looking like. Minus 700 now, TVP is going in front of us. He's trying to aim for my lower plate. Luckily, he's missing one shot. I'm trying to make a better angle, but it's not working that well. And we are getting destroyed. It is completely fine. You know what? I am very, very happy we are having battles like this. Why so? Look. The first battle was when all stars was aligning, right? I believe you would agree with that. Enemies is going in front, kaboom, 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 shooting to the left, shooting to the right, and dealing with everyone, right? And in this battle, we had completely different situation. We was trying to craft the use, but enemy team was better. They did better decisions. They eliminated pretty much both sides, and our team simply... could not do anything right there. Although I am feeling quite good with my decisions, apart the blind shots, right? Because I don't really think we hit someone. Yep, we definitely didn't hit anyone over there. Although 4 shots, solid 3000 damage right there. I am accepting that. Better luck next time. Are you ready for last one? Skill we are. Affirmative. Let's go for the last round with 268. Maybe we will get some Bushwanker map. Studzanke, funny thing, Studzanke is Bushwanker map, to be honest. You need to be extremely, extremely, extremely patient. And there is a couple of ways, probably there is 3 ways how to play this battle with the Time Destroyer. Option number 1, option number 2, option number 3. That's it. There is 3 ways how you can play this game mode or this map overall, right? And by the way, fellas, if you would pay attention, this map is looking like I won't say how this map is looking like because I am afraid of that. Okay, pay attention, fellas, pay attention. Or maybe I am only one naughty in this way. Yeah, you never know. Anyways, what we are going to do here, boys and girls, once again, we are taking the typical strategy, we are taking this position over there, and we are simply waiting until the enemies will do something stupid. For example, those Ferraris is going like crazy right here, Schnee. Easy game. Easy game. Beautiful. So far, so good. The first shot pre-aimed ideally. Looks like I am fully awake now, and my brain is saying, give me more of those. Looks like that's what is happening now. Okay, chill. Whenever someone is going to get spotted over there, we will... Actually, should I go for a blind shot? But skill, someone will get spotted. Shit! No one will. Or maybe. Okay, look, there is a gap. There is a gap over there. If someone is going to make one or another bad decision over there, we will try to obviously shoot them. Patton. Maybe Patton is going aggressively. If so, we can punish him. Come on, Patton. Actually, this is such a disgusting angle for us. Aim was good and everything was made quite well, but the pixel was simply too small. It happens sometimes. What is up now with this situation, right? There is so many houses in front of us, it is insane. It is literally insane. So this is no bueno stuff. Whenever you are playing over there, boys and girls, make sure to destroy a couple of houses, right? So you will have way easier shots and you won't have those awkward situations as I do now, okay? 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, look, we have a lot of guns over there, or more than enough guns over there. So what I need to do, I need to use my alpha damage over there, right? That's what I need to do. I will spot and I will use my alpha damage. This is very, very important thing. So be patient, but in the same time, be aggressive in the same time. I know sounds weird, but it is definitely the case. So we are going to feed ourselves. We are going to be well fed with assisting damage and with a damage dealt, which is completely fine, right? So once again, patience, patience, patience. And be aggressive in the same time. Once again, this Esterva is just beautiful cookie, which is going to provide us with a lot of use over there. And this is very, very important thing. Okay. Kranwagen is looking our back right there, which is understandable. Which is understandable. And I think this EBR had my camo and he went in front while having his gun raised. I might be wrong, but I think that was the case, okay? And if that was the case, then he probably wanted to salute me. Sometimes it's happening, fellas, when I am meeting people in the battlefield, which is raising the gun and they are not shooting. So usually I do not shoot them back, right? We are having a dance, we are having the giggle, and we are having some fun, right? It happened multiple times during the live streams and so on. I am not entirely sure that was a bad play from that person perspective, or he simply wanted to make a pressure idea, you never know. Either way, probably we will never ever figure this out. Going for a blind shot, obviously did not manage it to hit it, but it's completely fine. Now, what we need to do, we need to escape. Why we need to escape? Well, escape in a way. Look, whenever enemies will try to make a bit of pressure like this, we are going to see them, right? And this is very, very important thing. So I am pretty much waiting until enemy will F up. They have their Patton in the back, right? And they have the STB in the back. So the most important thing for me is just to stay patient and wait until they are going to make a pressure over there. By the way, I don't know, did you know? I don't know, did you notice it, dead boys and girls, but our Kranwagen escaped from over there, right? Well, he did not escape it, he got killed, but it's the same. He's not in the same position anymore, so this is very, very important information for us, right? Wait a bit. There is a big chance if this guy will go around, maybe we can have an angle to punish him. By the way, our EBR is dancing together with this Progetto, but still. It's not what I want, boys and girls. It is not what I want. Let's see. I am trying to craft a better angle right there. Oh. STB. Come on. No. I did not have fast enough reaction right there. That sucks. Good. Punishment shot into the Super Conqueror. That's very, very nice. And what we need to do now, we need to make a pressure like this, okay? We need to make a pressure like this because there is a big chance the pattern is not over there anymore. So what we are going to do? Pattern is over there. Russia. Good. That was super important shot. Now what we need to do? We need to deal with the Super Kong. He should be over there. So far so good. So far, so good. I could actually go and take one for the team and simply eliminate him from the game, and probably this is the most important thing for us right now, as wrong as it sounds. Ay, the most important shot of the game. I was trying to aim for a neck of the Super Conqueror, and I could definitely penetrate him. Either way, not a terrible game. So what did I did in this battle? I wasn't talking that much in this game because there was I was trying to focus on the battle right there, right? Not to get flanked, to be in the good position, and so on, so on. And the funny thing, where we were, we were playing at this area right there, just because it is amazing position. Why try to research a bicycle when the bicycle is right there? This is the position where you can get shit on of stuff, right? So what we have done right there before everything, uno momento. Chukst, inappropriate behavior in the chat. Very nice. So what we have done right here, we tried to secure this position, we played quite well in my opinion, we got 3.2000 damage and 2.6000 assisting slash tracking slash whatever damage, right? And it was a good game, we did as much as we could right here, right? It was fine, and in fact I'm happy, I was interested in this battle and I was trying to focus on this game. That was good, fellas. That was very, very good. Anyways, what we are going to do, we are going to skip to the ending now, so we won't wait until this Esterway is going to get gangbanged, and then we'll see the average performance with 268. My average performance overall with that tank, and average performance in this session. And you can see, and you will see everything yourself, boys and girls, okay? So, see you in a minute. Peace. Or maybe see you in a second. It took literally 15 seconds and Schnei jackpies the manager to find the shot into the Esterva, and Esterva got killed. It's okay, fellas, you cannot win them all, and I am quite happy with the result. And as wrong as it sounds, sometimes results are way better when you are losing the games, because you can actually farm more. Yes, you are losing your win ratio and you are not winning, but you can have a better performance. So yeah. We managed to score 3.2000 and 2.8000, and overall, on average, with this tank, how we are playing with this tank overall? 3.7000 damage and 900 assisting damage, right? And this session was 4.2000 average damage and 1000 average assisting damage. That was a good game. I am extremely, extremely happy with this session. And my lovely friends, baboons, comrades, maybe it's the time to take 268 and to go in the battlefield to have some fun, to dust the tank, and when you will notice the tank is it's out of this world, then put it in the darkest corner in the garage once again. Anyways, fellas, thank you so much for watching. That was your daily dose of skill. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for all your warm feedback, likes, patrons, which is supporting this disgusting caco. Obviously, everyone which is tuning in into the stream, I am very, very grateful for that. So thank you so much, fellas, and see you around. Peace.